بسم الله، الحمد لله والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the North Hudson Islamic Education Center, I'd like to welcome you all to our annual fundraising dinner. أهلا وسهلا بكم جميعا. It's my pleasure to be your host for tonight. This year's theme, inshallah, is Together for our Masjid. Alhamdulillah, we have an amazing community, a community of sustainers, of volunteers, and we're all here to serve you, and we know that you're here to serve the broader community. So we thank you all for coming, we thank you all for being here, we thank you all for your continuous support. We have a packed agenda for the night, inshallah, but there's no better way than to begin than with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with that, I ask my dear brother Omar Saleh to bless us, bless this gathering with the ayat, and we thank you, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ومن جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى لا شريك له تكسب كل نفس إلا عليها. ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى، ثم إلى ربكم مرجعكم in
Tawfiq, Brother Omar, for that heartwarming recitation. I apologize if I have a bit of a scratchy voice. I've been having a sore throat for about a week. Not enough doctors on the board, so. Next up, I'd like to invite Sister Ayat Safi to come and just read the translation of the ayat for the Omar recital. Clap afterwards.
Whoever has done a good deed will have it 10 times to his credit, but whoever has done a bad deed will be repaid only with its equivalent. They will not be wronged. Say, my Lord has guided me to a straight path, an upright religion, the faith of Abraham, a man of pure faith. He was not a polytheist. Say, my prayer and sacrifice, my life and death are all for God, Lord of all the worlds. He has no partner. This is what I am commanded, and I am the first to devote him to myself. Say, should I seek a Lord other than God when he is the Lord of all things? Each soul is responsible for its own actions. No soul will bear the burden of another. You will all return to your Lord in the end, and he will tell you the truth about your differences. It is he who made you successors on the earth and raises some of you above others in rank to test you through what he gives you. Prophet, your Lord swift in punishment, yet he is the most forgiving and merciful.
Thank you for that, Sister Aya. Next up, I'd like to invite to the stage someone that is I'm sure familiar to you all. I'd like to invite for the welcoming remarks Brother Murad, the chairman of the board. Khalil Muhammad.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. On behalf, it is my greatest pleasure to stand here in front of you on behalf of the Board of Trustees, the Executive Committee, our beloved Mashayikh, and all our volunteers and working staff in our center. We thank you very much for answering the call to attend our event tonight, inshallah. Brothers and sisters, this center, first of all, continues to grow. Firstly, by the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and secondly, by your support, all of you, each one of you. Every time we called on you to come to support our center, you were here for us, day in and day out, year in and year out. We are constantly working on improving all our existing programs in our center. We're also working constantly on creating new programs to benefit you, our community first, and benefit our center. I'd like to thank all the organizations, all the brothers and sisters, the businesses that sponsored our event. They will be announced later on during the event, inshallah. I'd like also to thank Mayor Brian Stagg, the Board of Education of Union City, for giving us this beautiful space to have our event and to hold our event in it. Lastly, I would love to thank our Sheikh, beloved Sheikh Saeed Qasabi, for being here for us tonight as our guest speaker tonight. I don't want to take much longer with your time. I would like to thank you all again, once for all, and thank you very
much. JazakAllah khairan, barakAllah feekum for that. So those were the activities of the center. So we're actually missing the narrator for the video, Morgan Freeman. I mean, that hot joke. But anyways, I want to give a special shout out to Abdul, our IT specialist, who came up with the whole video. So please, a big round of applause for Abdul. Okay, next up, we'd like to invite some of the RSA kindergarten and first grade class to come and perform an Ashid. So they can come up. I need one additional round of applause for the RSA kindergarten. And now I hope you all came with empty stomachs and a good appetite. I'd like to thank Davna Restaurant for catering for us tonight, inshallah. And if we could please ask everybody that's kind of spread out, kind of come together so that every table is filled. And that way there's enough room for everybody, inshallah. We'll take a brief break for everybody to get settled with the food, inshallah, and then we'll reconvene with the program.
Unity. So as you decide how much money you're going to give to this masjid, I don't want you to think about our efforts at getting people to become Muslim. I want you to think about helping people to stay Muslim. Because I've been Muslim, alhamdulillah, for 17 years. And it's because of the robust efforts of this community. So don't think about the Muslims who are going to convert today or next week. I want you to think about the fact that we want our children and our grandchildren to have a community and have a place to pray. And when you sign your check or reach into your pocket, I want you to keep that in mind. Because Islam is not just in front of us today. Islam has to last for several generations after we're all dead and gone. Jazakallah khair.
إخواني الله يكرمكم. I know براء is going to kill me now. جزاكم الله خيرا. All of the دعوة supporters, I know, I probably, Allah knows them. They're here tonight. The ones who support the monthly putluck for the دعوة. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. May Allah reward them. And all of you who will give tonight for this masjid, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala barik fihum wa fi amwalihim wa fi iyalihim wa fi diyarihim wa ihfadhum. Shukran.
Barakallahu fik shaykhna. Jazakallahu khair, Sister Candice and Brother Andreas. Actually, Sister Candice is my history teacher, so I think some credit for that. So next up, I'd like to invite to the stage, inshallah, some of the youth committee who are going to share with us their experience and some of what they learned. And to begin, inshallah, we're going to start with the boys' youth. And on their behalf, and speaking for them, is going to be Brother Ali Mahi. Please give a warm welcome to him. This is passing.
Assalamu alaikum. How's everybody doing?
Good.
I hope you guys are enjoying your food. So I just want to start by sharing my personal connection with this masjid. I've been attending this masjid since I was like 6 years old. I attended the no school, the Saturday school. And you know, when I started going to school, that's when I met Amu Salman, and he introduced me to basketball, and that basically, you know, they had a basketball team, so I started playing for them and stuff. So that just brought me closer to the masjid. And as you know, as I grew older, I lived right next to the masjid, so I was there practically every day. So yeah. Now when I grew, like as I grew older in the masjid, I met many people, made many great connections that shared the last a lifetime. So a few years ago, I met Brother Kamad, who also became my basketball coach. And he started, we had a youth program, but then he took over, and that's how we all got together as friends. With him, we come together every Friday at night from 7 to like 9. And we have a football with either Brother Bara or Brother Diop. He's here somewhere. And then we get together and play a little basketball, and you know, we just build brotherhood together. So yeah.
He's nervous. It's fine. He did fine. Thank you, brothers, for all that. Thank you for sharing your experience. That's Ali Mahin again and his security guards. Round of applause, please. Next up, I'd like to invite some representatives from the girls' youth, inshallah, who will be talking about their experience. I'd like to invite to the stage Sister Yasmeen Ahmed, Safiya Mahin, and Noura Muhammad. Let's see if they all shine the boys. Thank you.
saying that NHIEC was not only a mentor for me, but it was also my second home. Sophia and I, along with many other girls, were basically raised in this masjid, and this masjid has helped me in so many ways, and is still currently helping me to grow into the person that I aspire to be. I've started coming to this masjid when I was around 2 years old, and I'm very proud to say that this masjid has been improved in so many ways that I cannot even list. I've noticed that the youth program has been so much more coordinated and organized, and that the masjid has been giving girls so many opportunities that are beyond imaginable. For example, Girls Youth was told to choose a few girls to be part of the masjid's committee, and to represent the voice for all girls in the masjid. All these opportunities that we were blessed with is what makes this masjid such a welcoming and valuable place. I've also noticed that I, along with many other girls, have started coming to this masjid a lot more often than usual. And I can't get my fingers wrapped around as to why we are, but there's something so special about this masjid that always has us coming back.
This masjid has provided a spiritual outlet for me and various other people through its youth program. Through our halaqas, Quran and Tajweed classes, and many other programs and activities, I gained the knowledge that I lacked being a public school student, where no one ever speaks about religion. I now find myself doing my own research because I am so eager to find out more about my deen and the history behind it. This program provides a sense of community for me. In today's day and age, it's very easy to fall in a path away from your religion. I have found an amazing connection with Allah, and that helped prevent me from falling down this road. I have made so many lifelong friends that encouraged me to strengthen my iman rather than being pushed away from it. Together, we are planning to make a difference in our own lives as well as in others' lives by doing charity volunteer work, as well as learning about Islam and valuable leadership skills. And in order to reach that goal, we need the support from each and every one of you. Each one of you is different from the rest, and each one of you has something unique to contribute to the masjid.
NHIEC might not be a perfect masjid, but with the help of each and every one of you, we can make this very masjid a masjid that is worthwhile. And we are very honored to say that NHIEC is our masjid. Thank you.
Before we introduce them, I want to just thank the girls and boys youth, and specifically I'd like to thank the youth director for putting together a great and awesome program. Please give a loud and warm applause for Abu Hamza Kamal Ahmed. He's here. Inshallah, next up we have some Quran recitation from in Noor School. We have, inshallah, first going is Sheikh Mashkur Salim, who's going to be reciting from Surah Al-Zalzal. If we can ask everyone in the back specifically, please, to just put the noise level down a bit, because the sound system is not the greatest. Next up, we're gonna have Brother Yasin Ali recite from Surah Al-Adiyah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعاديات ضبحا فالموريات قدحا فالمغيرات صبحا فأثرن به نقعا فوسطن به جمعا إن الإنسان لربه لكنود وإنه على ذلك لشهيد وإنه لحب الخير لشهيد أفلا يعلم إذا بعثر ما في القبور وحصل ما في الصدور إن ربهم بهم يومئذ لخبير صدق الله العظيم.
تكبير تكبير. بارك الله فيكم. You guys can go up now. Next up, I'd like to invite to the stage Sister Sausek and Shayna.
Assalamu alaikum. Fadlul walidayn. Hubbi ilayhum la yudaahi ba'ada. Hubbi li rabbi wa nabi Muhammada. Abawaya lawyatu alayna bilrida. يكن الطريق إلى الجنان ممهدا أبوايا كنتم على الدوام منعدلا كي تجعلوني بين قومي سيدا وأخذت منكم ما يجب وزيادة وكأنكم جمتموني واحدا وكنت أطلب ما لكم تعطون لم تدخلوا لم تجعلوه مهددا وبدأ عليكم إذا مرضت كآبة وإذا شفيت يزيد عنكم ما بدأ وإن تسمع أني أحقق مطلبا كنتم لأجلي تفرحان وتسعدا اليوم أخبر والدي بأنه حبي إليهم في الفؤاد ممددا الشمس شهدت والسماء بعدلها والقمر يشهد والسحاب مؤيدا والله يشهد لا أبالغ مطلقا هل مثل ربي في الشهادة شاهدا يا ربي تحفظ والدي كلاهما واجعل لهم من حوض طه موردا واكتب لهم حسن الختام لأنه باب العبور إلى النعيم خالدا.
بارك الله فيكم فيهم جزاكم الله خيرا. Next up, I'd like to invite to the stage someone who runs one of our most successful programs, the Masjid program that's been going on for years and years, and I'm sure many of your children attend this and inshallah can defend themselves as a result of that. So I'd like you all to put your hands together for Brother Ala Abu Rida.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. So thank you guys for having me today. Inshallah I'll be very quick. So alhamdulillah, my name is Brother Ala. For those who may know me, I am the taekwondo instructor for ITIEC. Alhamdulillah, it's my greatest pleasure. The first thing is I trained in this masjid. I've been going there since attending since I was 5 years old. Sheikh Al-Hayek, mashallah, was one of my dearest teachers. And I also learned Taekwondo in this masjid, alhamdulillah. And the second pleasure is, of course, taking a break and praying behind Sheikh Hasan Saleh while we are training, alhamdulillah. So this is our Taekwondo program is not just about, kicking wood and going to tournaments. Alhamdulillah, we like to, instill in our students confidence, self-esteem, self-defense. Alhamdulillah, we know life is rough, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared us for life. In the Quran, He lets us know that we will be tested with fear and hunger. And, He gives glad tidings to those who are patient. And Prophet Muhammad said, that he gave us a dua to seek protection in Allah from cowardice, from fear, from being overpowered by men. So in our program, we instill in our children, you know, goal setting and confidence and self-esteem. Alhamdulillah, our students go to tournaments and they spar with students from all over the area, alhamdulillah, Muslim and non-Muslim alike as well. And if I can quickly mention, Harvard University did a recent study, and this, he said the two things that determine success in life, the first one is self-control and discipline, and the second is emotional intelligence. So in our program, we want to emphasize for our students to have self-control and discipline. Alhamdulillah, we have a belt program. Students work hard to achieve the next belt and focus on these tasks, alhamdulillah. And you know, I myself, alhamdulillah, I'm an educator and I'm a father. And I see a lot of benefits, inshallah, for martial arts. I think, you know, no matter what art they do or where it is, we would love them to join our program. But martial arts is beneficial for the human being, alhamdulillah, especially at Muslim kids. You know, bullying is very popular, it's very common nowadays. You know, I'm a high school teacher in the Bronx. In a rough neighborhood, I see it all the time. So alhamdulillah, we want our students to know this is not just about kicking the bag and going home. We want them to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the first thing, to be involved in the community, to have shaja'ah and a shakhsiyah, right? And to have courage and confidence, alhamdulillah. So, you know, I'm very proud of our students. I'm very honored to have access to so many youth, alhamdulillah. I've been teaching taekwondo now for about 15 years. I've taught hundreds of students, alhamdulillah. It's my greatest pleasure. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, protect our children all the time and strengthen us as a community. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, BarakAllahu Feek, for that. And now, before we begin, before I introduce our keynote speaker, we actually have one more segment. Just before that, I'd like to invite, before I begin, Sheikh Muhammad Musa, and Brother Abdul Murad, the Chairman of the Board. Inshallah, as we've made it a habit every year to recognize some honorees and to recognize people who've been part of this community for all the years, inshallah, this year we're recognizing two individuals whom have been with the masjid since its inception and who have been not only helping sustain it financially, but have also been in the forefront of the efforts to volunteer and have people volunteer there. And those two brothers, and I'm just going to wait for everyone to pick them up, those two brothers, alhamdulillah, unfortunately, they were unable to attend. So inshallah, we're going to ask some people to take the awards on their behalf. Abu Murad,
in the shirt.
Inshallah, the first award goes to an appreciation for over 25 years of service and continuous service and support, Dr. Saeed Abbasi. Please put your hands together. And to take on his behalf, his brother, Abu Isa. This next brother is also someone who has been part of this community since its inception and is someone who's also helped it in the same fashion. And in appreciation for over 25 years of continuous service and support, we'd like to thank and appreciate Diab Saleh. His son Muqtasim, inshallah, will be here to take the award on his behalf. Exactly. Okay, we can ask everyone to please, especially in the back, just to take a seat. Inshallah, I'm going to invite up to the stage our keynote speaker of the night. It's a man who needs no introduction, someone that's familiar to us all, the Imam and Sheikh of the Islamic Center of Union County, Sheikh Sa'id Al-Qasabi.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه صلاة ترضى بها عنا يوم أن نلقاك يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل جمعنا الليلة جمعا مرحوما، واجعل افتراقنا من بعده معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تحرم هذه الوجوه على النار. اللهم لا تخرجنا من هذا المكان إلا وقد غفرت لنا ورضيت عنا أجمعين بكرمك وجودك أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. في البداية أشكر لإخواني جميعا في مسجد نورث برغن، يعني روادا وإدارة وإماما هذه الدعوة الطيبة. سعدت بهذه الدعوة، أسأل الله أن يتقبل مني ومنكم وأن يوفقنا لما جئنا من أجله في هذه الليلة. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. لن أتحدث كثيرا وإن كنت جئت متحدثا، لكن مشهد الأطفال الصغار، سواء أبنائنا الصغار اللي كانوا بيعملوا أنشودة القرآن، أو أطفالنا الصغار اللي قرأوا القرآن، أو بناتنا اللي كانوا بينشدوا عن بر الوالدين، أو بناتنا الذين كانوا قبلهم، أو الأولاد، والله حقيقة يعني غيروا ما أردت أن أتحدث عنه. إذا كنا بالفعل نحتاج إلى محفز ونحتاج إلى دافع ونحتاج إلى حافظ يحفظنا وينشطنا ويدفعنا إلى الاهتمام بمساجدنا، فرؤية أطفالنا الصغار وأولادنا وبناتنا هذه يعني خير حافظ وخير دافع يدفعنا إلى الخير. ما دام عندنا هذا الجيل، ما دام عندنا هذا النشء، ما دام عندنا يعني هذه الزهرات وهذا النوع من الأشبال، جزى الله خيرا كل من شارك في تعليمهن وفي تعليمهم. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. أبشر الإخوة والأخوات القائمين على هذا العمل، على تعليم الأبناء وعلى تعليم البنات، بما جاء في الأثر أنه إذا حفظ الطفل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، إذا حفظ الطفل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وليس فقط سورة الزلزال والعاديات وما سمعنا، إذا حفظ الطفل بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم غفر الله بها لثلاثة، غفر الله بها لثلاثة، غفر بها للطفل ولمن حفظه ولوالديه، غفر للطفل ولمن حفظه ولوالديه. يعني الحقيقة هذا جهد طيب، ربنا يتقبل من كل من ساهم فيه ومن كل من رتب له ومن كل من أعد له. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. يا إخوة، ساعات ديننا يحتاج منا أن نقف بأبداننا لندافع عنه، وساعات أخرى يحتاج ديننا أن نقف بألسنتنا لنتحدث وندافع عنه، وساعات أخرى يحتاج منا ديننا أن نقف بأموالنا لندافع عنه. أظننا اليوم نحتاج أن ندافع عن ديننا، ونحتاج أن ندعم يعني رسالتنا، وأن ندعم أهدافنا بأموالنا وليس فقط بكلامنا ولا بأبداننا. إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة. مجال القول يعني هذا مجال، ومجال الفعل يعني هو مجال آخر. كنت أتحدث منذ أسبوع أو أسبوعين في موضوع حسن الخاتمة، أسأل الله أن يحسن لي ولكم الخاتمة. اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. فتطرقت إلى حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، إذا أحب الله عبدا استعمله، وفي رواية إذا أحب الله عبدا عسله. قالوا كيف يا رسول الله؟ قال يوفقه لعمل خير يقبضه عليه. العام الماضي جاءني أخ من كوينز يوم الجمعة، هذا يعني تحديدا هنذكر الأيام، الجمعة السبت الأحد تحديدا، جاني أخ من كوينز اسمه أبو عبد الله يوم الجمعة، وطلب مني بعد صلاة الجمعة تبرعات لمسجد في كوينز. تكلفة المسجد 2 مليون، وكان محتاج دعم من المسجد. قلت له أنت جيت متأخر، ما رتبتش مع الإدارة، إن شاء الله يعني الأسبوع القادم نعمل فندريزة للمسجد ونقوم معكم بالواجب إن شاء الله. صرف الرجل شاكرا، ثم اتصل بي يوم السبت يوم الثاني، قال والله أنت رجل طيب، ربنا أكرمنا، أول مسجد جيناكم أنتم. بعد ما ذهبت اتصل بي احد الاخوه واخذ مني العنوان وجاءني واعطاني شك بمليون دولار. والله مليون دولار، انا طبعا يعني كلمه مليون دولار من تكلفه المبنى 2 مليون، يعني في كلمه واحده الرجل واحد تبرع بنصف المبلغ تماما. قال لي معايا الآن شك بمليون دولار، نصف المبلغ بقي النصف الآخر. الكلام ده يوم الايه؟ يوم السبت. يوم الأحد اتصل بي الأخ أبو عبد الله وهو يبكي، بيقول لي يا أخي الأخ الذي أعطاني شك بمليون دولار توفى الآن. والله قال لي توفى الآن. هارد أتاك، والأخ صغير في السن تقريبا 45 سنة أو 55 سنة، يعني مش راجل عجوز ومش مريض. أنا فوجئت جدا والله، قلت له والله عن جد. قال لي والله بالفعل الأخ أعطاني الشك يوم السبت، توفى يوم الأحد تقريبا مات بعد صلاة الفجر أو بعد صلاة الظهر لا أدري، بس كلمني هو بعد صلاة الظهر. قال لي الأخ توفى. فقلت له يعني في أسرع وقت لابد أن أنت تصرف الشك النهارده لسببين اثنين. السبب الأول لتكيش الشك، لا أدري ماذا يفعل أبناء المرحوم، مش عارف. الرجل تبرع مبلغ كبير جدا، وقد يعني الدنيا تشغل أولاده ويمتنع عن صرف الشك، وأبونا مات وإلى آخره. والنقطة الثانية التي أردتها، أردت أن يدخل هذا الشك في حساب المسجد قبل أن يدخل هذا الرجل إلى قبره، ليكون له نورا في قبره. تسميها حسن خاتمة، تسميها حظ طيب، سميها كما شئت، لكن الرجل كما علمنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، كما علمنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن النفقة الصحيحة أن تنفق وأنت شحيح، تحب الدنيا وتكره الموت. يعني وإحنا بصحتنا ما شاء الله كلنا كده، وربنا يعطي الجميع صحته، ينفق هو مستقبل الدنيا وليس مدبر عنها. والله يا إخوة لا ندري ماذا يحدث غدا. ديننا يحتاج إلينا، وإسلامنا يحتاج إلينا، وبلدنا هذا يحتاج إلينا، أبناؤنا هذا الجيل، بيت الله تبارك وتعالى يحتاج إلينا. ها أنتم هؤلاء تدعون لتنفقوا في سبيل الله، فمنكم من يبخل، ومن يبخل فإنما يبخل عن نفسه، والله الغني وأنتم الفقراء، وإن تتولوا يستبدل قوما غيركم ثم لا يكونوا أمثالكم. دائما أحب أن تقوم الجالية بنفسها، ورأيت يعني في هذا العرض السابق والله ما شاء الله أنشطة كثيرة جدا، أسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يتقبل منكم جميعا. أختم وأقول هذا المسجد نورث برغن، وقد خطبت فيه أكثر من مرة، هذا المسجد محظوظ بمكانه وبرواده وبإدارته، ومن الله تبارك وتعالى عليكم بشيخين جليلين أحسبهما على خير ولا أزكيهما على الله تبارك وتعالى. تتهافت إليهم الأسماع ويأتي الناس إليهم من كل حدب وصوب، سواء فضيلة الدكتور محمد موسى أو فضيلة الشيخ حسن صالح، فأنتم محظوظون على هذا المسجد، يعني فيه بركة، فيه خير، فيه نور، فيه رجال يحبون أن يتطهروا، والله يحب المطهرين. أسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يوفقنا في هذه الليلة لما جئنا من أجله، وأن يعني يرزق الجميع حسن النفقة وحسن البذل، وأن يجعلنا من عمار المساجد ومن رواد المساجد، وأن يحقق غايتنا في هذه الليلة المباركة، وأن لا يخرجنا من هذا الوقت المبارك إلا وقد غفر لنا، اللهم أمين يا رب العالمين. النقطة التي أختم بها وتركتها للنهاية، الإخوة اللي أعلنوا تحدثوا عن إعلان الإسلام، الأخت اللي من 17 years والأخ اللي يتحدث قبلها ويتحدثوا عن الشيخ الحايك، أغبط هذا الرجل والله، لأن النبي علمنا الآن يهدينا الله بك رجلا واحدا. طب وبقى ما شاء الله النماذج اللي بنشوفها عن الشيخ الحايك وأرى على الفيسبوك والأنشطة التي يقوم بها، أسأل الله أن يتقبل من الجميع، وأن يجعل هذا يا شيخ محمد في ميزان حسناتك وحسنات الجميع، وأن يتقبل منا ومنكم. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.